here. This is Warhammer End Times Vermintide. Yes, I know it's been out for a little while, and you've most likely seen videos all over the gaff of it, but I'm quite enjoying this thing, so I figured I'd make one. What is it? It's a, well, whatever you call these things these days, horde shooter, co-op FPS action. It's basically Left 4 Dead in the Warhammer universe, I suppose, is the shorthand way. And it dumps you straight into this inn. There's no title screen, really. You get a launcher, hit start game, and it puts you straight into this. But we can hit escape and have a quick look at the options menu. We have some gameplay settings. We have a field of view slider, which is important for some people. Goes up to 120. 65 is the default. Max upload speed, which you can change, which is a bit weird. It's a peer-to-peer game, I suppose, so you want it as high as you can. Especially if you're the host. It defaults to 512 kilobits. I've bumped it up a little bit there. Some display settings. You can pause this stuff if you want to look for something specific. Decent graphics options. Nothing really missing here. Decent looking games, a DirectX 11 release. We have some audio sliders, voice over IP is on by default. Key bindings, always nice to see. And some gamepad settings, apparently it plays quite well with the controller if you're one of those people that likes to play on their couch and stuff. So, let's head into the inn, which should start some moody music. And this guy should start talking. Come on, fella, say something.
We lost another safe house last night. This keeps up, we'll be all that's left.
Yeah, he's really calm for someone in the end time, stuck in a town, overrun by Skaven, and that's what this game is. Because this universe doesn't exist anymore, right? It's all Age of Sigmar now. So this is telling one of the many stories of the end times, and whenever a big universe like Warhammer ends, you have the opportunity for some really great narrative stuff, and in this case, we're a bunch of characters stuck in an inn, trying to either get out of this city or save it or something. And here is the city. What is it called? Uber Strike. I'm sure I'm saying that incorrectly, but they have it, and this is where you select missions from. At the moment, I am a bright wizard. You can tell by my icon in the bottom right. There are a bunch of heroes to select from. Let's have a quick look at them. We have Victor Saltspire, who's a witch hunter. Very smarmy. We have Carillion, who's a way watcher with a Scottish accent, which is important. We have Bardin Gorixson, a dwarf ranger, looking very dwarven. And Sienna Fuaganasis, a bright wizard, who is the person I was just playing. And Marcus Kruber, a soldier. Now, it doesn't do a huge amount of narrative setup or character setup, but there are a lot of pretty amusing and nicely done quips and banter as you're doing the missions, which I haven't got sick of yet, but I'm sure if you play hours and hours and hours and hours, they might get a bit grating. But so far, so good for that stuff. So how does this game work in combat? You have a melee weapon and a ranged weapon. This is my melee weapon as a bright wizard. It's a longsword. Those are my charged attacks. If I time it right, I can get another swing the other way. There we go. I've got a 3-hit combo. But of course, this is all different for the different weapons. I can also block by holding right click. And it gives me those 3 shields. That's my stamina, which changes from weapon loadout to weapon loadout. Basically, as I take hits and block them, those shields will deplete, and when they run out, I not only lose the ability to block until they recharge, I also stagger slightly. So you don't want to run out of that stuff, you want to get away before it runs out, because if you stagger, you're going to take more hits. I can also push if I hit the left mouse button while I'm holding down the right like this, which also depletes my stamina quite heavily, as you can see there. Just 3 pushes and you're out of it. Pushing is important. Yeah, it's telling me that I'm fatigued on the back there. Pushing is important. Not only does it knock stuff away from you, it also acts as a taunt. So if you see... Yeah, be quiet. If I see an ally in trouble, I can run up and hit push, and they'll all turn around and try and attack me once they recover from their stagger. So it's very important, especially for the dwarf ranger and the soldier who are often tanking with a shield and that kind of thing. I want to draw aggro. I've also got a ranged weapon. I can hit Q to quickly switch to it, which is really useful. Now, the Bright Wizard is different in that her ranged weapon is not limited by ammo, which you collect throughout the level. It's limited by her level of heat. She's a pyromaniac, fire wizard type thing, if you hadn't guessed. And as she uses her staff, she builds up her heat level. You can see it in the center of the screen. You can also see it on the right side there near my staff icon. If you heat up too much, you will literally explode, doing a bunch of damage to the things around you and killing yourself. There we go, it's telling me to be careful. I'm on fire now. It's not doing damage to me, but I need to wait to cool down. You can also vent your heat by holding down R by default, which cools you down quicker, but you can't move very quickly while you're venting, so it's something you generally want to do between engagements. So that's my basic attack, which is pretty damn strong. The range attacks are pretty strong in this game and will one-shot most of the smaller Skaven on normal mode, in a way, not on hard mode. And I do have a charged attack as well. If I hold down the right mouse button, she's going to do this, and then I hit left mouse button, shoots a big-ass fireball. Now, it's a fireball because I'm using a fireball staff. If I go into the inventory, look at my ranged weapons, I also have this conflagration staff. If I equip that, it's going to completely change my charged attack. As you can see, it now highlights an area on the ground and basically sets it on fire. So you have a bigger area of effect and a lot of burn damage, but I generally prefer the big impact and knockback strength of the fireball staff. And I've got a nice blue one, which is socketed with bloodlust and haste. Some very small chances to buff. Most of the sockets don't give you a lot of chance for stuff to happen. I guess they didn't want new players to feel really underpowered, so the weapons don't buff you up that much. I am level 8. I'm not sure what leveling does. I don't think it does anything for your basic statistics. It just gives you items as you level up. Some very basic items usually. So there's a forge over here. Let's have a look. This is where you can fuse items, add 5 items of the same rarity to get a new one. I can't actually do that at the moment. I don't have 5 items. Well, I do have 5 greens, but the dwarf is using this two-handed hammer, and since I don't have another melee weapon for him, I can't take that off him to do it, or I would. I've not played any of the other characters, so I just concentrate on getting stuff for my Bright Wizard. You can also upgrade, which is how you unlock these sockets. Basically, you drag drag an item in, and you spend these curious resources, which don't seem to have a name, and you can unlock these abilities, and it tells you what you need to do it. I'm not entirely sure how you get these things. Do you get them from missions, or you only get them from salvaging? Here's a salvage mechanic. Is this something we can salvage? Surely there is. Come on now. Yes, we can salvage this trusty harquebus, however you say that. There we go. And we got 2 of those things. Wonderful. There's also another mechanic when fighting. It's called a special attack. The Bright Wizard can't do it, but if I switch to the Witch Hunter, he can do it. So he's using his melee weapon now, which is a rapier. Very quick attack speed, balanced around headshots. I'll show you that in a minute. But if I hit the special attack button, which I have mapped to C, he does this. Pulls out his pistol for a quick shot. Isn't that cool? Now, I'm sure some of the other heroes have special attacks too, but this is the only one I know about. So if we look at his weapons, you see each weapon has traits in this green text here. So his normal attack has the headshot trait, and his charge attack also has the headshot trait, and also armor penetration. So this weapon, which has relatively low damage to rapier, but very quick attack speed, is obviously balanced around spamming those very quick attacks on the head, since you're doing extra headshot damage with those attacks. Pretty cool. And armor penetration means that you can penetrate armor of tougher enemies. And if I go back to my Bright Wizard, great thing about her staff is she gets armor penetration on the normal and charge attack, so she can still hit the armored enemies even without charging up her attack. Usually only the charge attacks have armor penetration. So that's pretty much it, I think, for the mechanics before we head into try and get a mission. So I'll see you in there, guys. So here we are, Uberstrike in 2523 apparently. This is like my 3rd time trying to record a game, because this game likes to crash when I end my recording, which then corrupts my recording, which is wonderfully fun. This game has been completely stable apart from that. No crashes, no performance problems whatsoever. But yeah, hopefully we get through it this time. This is the Horn of Magnus on hard mode, since I think these guys who I'm with, these are all Dawn of War 2 players. We've got Yorg, Pib, and Asinski, who you may recognize from Dawn of War 2 casts over the years that I've done. are all very experienced, as you can tell from their levels, and I think they're pretty bored of doing the Horde of Magnus on normal, so we're going to try it on hard. Now, there are a couple of things I forgot to mention in when I was mucking around in the inn earlier. First is your other equipment. On the right side, you can see three other slots. One of them is for a healing item, one of them is for a potion, which is basically a buff to yourself, and the other is for a grenade type thing, an explosive. On hard mode, you do not start with a healing item. On normal mode, you start with a healing draft, which is got a bomb, which is a self-healing item. There are also medical supplies, which are healing items you can use on yourself or on others, though they take quite a while to use. That's a horn, which usually means a bunch of rats are going to show up, I think. The other thing I forgot to mention is that you can dodge. If you hit the jump button and hold a direction that isn't forward, you will do a little dodge. As you can see here, I'm dodging side to side and backwards, but I need to concentrate on setting things on fire here. This is hard mode, so the rats are a hell of a lot tougher. Maybe twice as tough. You can't one-shot them with your ranged weapon nearly as much, and they do more damage. I'm definitely going to need to block a hell of a lot more often, which is something I'm pretty bad at. Okay, took that guy down. So when I just did the last run, which failed to record, obviously, I got a shotgun for the dwarf. I had no idea the dwarf could get a shotgun, and I'm definitely going to have to try that guy next because of that. I love me some shotguns. As I said before, I think in the inn video, oh, there's a Globadier. The Bright Wizard is the only class I've played so far. So there are several special types of rats. That one that just threw poison and I stupidly walked through is called a Globadier. There are several other much nastier ones. I just lost a bunch of health because I'm a fool and ran into trouble and completely missed that fireball. There we go. I also picked up a bolt staff, which is another type of staff I hadn't seen before. Attacks incredibly quickly. She like shoots fire out of her staff and her hands over and over and over again. There's also a beam staff, I think, that I've read about, which sounds cool. So a decent little variety in the loadouts you have for each character. But I'm happy with my fireball staff right now. These guys obviously know what they're doing. I think they're looking for tomes. Tomes are things you can get which will replace your healing item. But if you can get them through the level to the end, you get an extra dice for your loot roll. There are also things called grimoires, and I think they reduce the maximum health of the entire party. But if you can get those through the end of the level, obviously you get another loot dice to roll at the end, which of course increases your chance of getting good stuff. And the biggest complaint I've heard so far from the Dawn of War 2 players I know that play this game is the loot system. How random it is. Of course, oh, there's a phalanx. That's a like military patrol of tough dudes that you generally want to avoid. As I was saying, the loot system has been the biggest complaint. Obviously, there are a lot of games where you get random loot, but with those, you generally get a lot of random loot all the time, so you're going to find something good. With this, you only get something if you complete the mission. If you don't complete it, you get no loot whatsoever. You just get some XP. And as I said, XP just gives you like a common item. I don't know if they're random or if they're predefined as you go up the levels. Kind of a basic progression system, making sure you've got one of each weapon type or something. But yeah, the loot system is pretty harsh. You can do really well, then get to the end and die and get nothing. You might have heard some whispers a few minutes ago. That is the Gutter Runner Rat. He's an assassin and he's a pain in the ass. He goes invisible and then jumps on you and stabs the absolute crap out of you. I think he's just getting piv over there. Yeah, there he is. You see him go invisible again on hard mode. Much bigger pain in the ass since he's got some durability to him. And you generally want to wait until you've taken him out. There he is. He's on me. You generally want to wait until you've taken him out before you move on, because you might get a big spawn of rats. This game is kind of procedurally generated. There's another one, in that the engagements and the special rats that spawn are all randomized or generated. I don't know if there's some kind of AI to it, if it's modelled on how well you're doing or your party composition, or if you're just completely random, but you can get kind of screwed over when several special rats spawn all at once and make an engagement very, very tough. Okay. Indrid killed a poison wind globadier. Oh, go me. There's another bomb. I don't really want that. I want a healing item, please, game. Pip needs one too. Oh, it looks like he's carrying a totem, as you can see there, which has replaced his healing item, but you can pick them up momentarily, use the healing item, and then pick up the tome again.
Black ones.
Nice shot.
Looks like they want to skip the grimoires, which would have lowered our maximum health, which I guess is a good idea on hard mode with Nubdrid in your team. As I said though, in the inn, the leveling system is pretty horizontal, so you can do well with a low level character. You just won't have maybe a green or blue item. Where are those guys going? I don't know, I'm staying with Pip. Shoot him in the face. Shoot those guys. Are they going for the grimoire or something? Ammunition for those guys. I don't need to worry about that since I'm a mage and I shoot fire. So this is the place where you need to pick up barrels. Can be really brutal on hard mode, because one person is going to be carrying one of these, so you only have three that are fighting the hordes that come out. Seems to be a place where the ogre spawns quite a lot, which is not too bad since you generally want to fight the ogre in a nice open area. Pib is surrounded by a whole bunch of stuff. Throw some fireballs in there. Obviously don't want to overheat myself, which I've still never done. Maybe on the really high difficulty levels, you're kind of under pressure to spam those big fireballs over and over again against the big hordes. And it's a lot more dicey. Here we go. You can get tons of Skaven spawn. They can literally pile up on top of each other, which is pretty cool. The bodies do disappear, I guess, for performance reasons. The game does build some pretty nice tension when there's like a gutter runner skulking around or something. Although I guess it's kind of hard for them to keep that tension up when you play the maps over and over and over again. But generally on the first playthrough it is pretty damn fun and can be tense. So here's the third barrel we need. Just going to blow that door. Looks like we've got a spawn in the meantime. Through that door is a massive open area, which is another very popular place for the ogre to spawn. Ogres are scary. That's a gutter runner there. You see that guy glowing blue? That's because one of the team spotted him. Kind of like you can spot things in Battlefield games and stuff. I think it's mapped to T by default, which I found awkward, so I mapped it to F. Bunch more stuff here than there is on normal. Game is pretty easy on normal, honestly, on the maps I've played anyway. You don't need to worry about blocking too much. You can be surrounded and do pretty... Whoa. Bastard. I'm going to pick up this and use it. Use it. Use it. There we go. And then pick the tome back up. Osinski trying to line up a shot there. I'm going to throw a fireball in. And completely miss, obviously. There we go. And get some hits in. Everyone's good on health right now. Some more Skaven coming through. Combat's pretty good. It's satisfying. The melee has a crunch to it. And so have the ranged weapons as well. You feel suitably powerful when you're fighting a lot of the little fellas. And the big fellas are suitably scary. The ogre on hard mode is a beast. And you have the visual cues for the special rats. When the ogre's on the way, you hear him roar. When the gunner is around, which I haven't seen yet, you hear the mechanical sounds of his giant minigun thing. Which is pretty damn cool. Why don't we get miniguns? Should be able to pick it up or something. These guys on hard taking two heavy attacks to deal with. Usually on normal you can just decapitate a whole row of them with a special attack, which is incredibly satisfying. Okay, moving into this little area here. Watch of Skaven.
I'm ready.
I one-shotted that guy with my ranged attack. I guess the different little rats, or normal-sized ratmen, whatever, have their own behaviors and things, but I don't really notice that much difference between them apart from the weapons. Some of them have knives, some of them have these really long spears, which is annoying. Need to be careful of that range difference. There's a hook rat, which has got our dwarf and friend. That's one of the special rats. Luckily, he's generally quite easy to take down compared to some of the other specials, though he does drain your health while he's hooking you up and dragging you away. Where is he dragging you to? I'm not sure. I think they turn people into slaves or something. There is a revive mechanic. There's also like a why are you dying? Are you bugged? There is a few bugs in this game. You see floating rats and this kind of thing. There's a help up mechanic. If you go too close to an edge on certain maps, you'll kind of fall off it and be hanging on to the edge. Nobody in Vermintide is able to pull themselves up off a ledge, and you need to wait for help, which is a little bit gamey, I guess, but plays into the you need a team kind of thing. I'm down to half health. Pip is even lower. Okay, some medical supplies there. Someone might be able to heal me without me. Should I use it? A dwarf has got it. Okay. When you get revived, you get back up with around half health, but you are wounded. You are bleeding, and you'll be slowly losing health. Oh, that's on the Rat Ogre, I think. This is a really bad place to fight a Rat Ogre. You generally want to fight them in an open space. That was saying, yeah, when you get back up after being revived, you are wounded. Here's a Rat Ogre, and you need to use a healing item to stop yourself bleeding. The dwarf is going to try and tank this guy. I'm going to try and not explode myself. You can block the Rat Ogre's attacks, but it takes all of your stamina to do so. At least it takes all of mine, anyway, since I've only got 3 of those shields on this sword. You see how tough this guy is? Wow, it's almost taking me down. I need to keep my distance here. Getting way too close to it as a Bright Wizard, I think. I'm getting into here. Let the dwarf try and tank that guy. Just shot at Asinski. I thought it was a Skaven. Oh, we took it down. And there were 2 rattling gunners over there that Asinski took down. Awesome. I'm really low now. I am super, super low on health. Someone might want to heal me. Yep, Jorgis going to heal me. Thank you. Some nice banter between the characters, as I think I mentioned before in the inn. And it changes depending on who's in the party. You have 2-way banter. You have these 3-way exchanges too. The voice work is generally good. It's nice stuff. Wish there was a little bit more of it. Wish there was some more characters, but I guess that's prime DLC kind of stuff. New characters. That was another one of those rats that drag you off. I always forget their names. Pack Rat, I think. There are also 2 rats that I'm kind of confused about. They both seem to be these kind of heavily armored rats. One of them's called a Stormwind. The other's called a Commander. I'm not sure what the difference is. Maybe Commanders buff other rats around them or something, maybe? So, Jorg and Pib are kind of low on health, but this is on hard mode, so I think we're doing generally well. The Horn of Magnus is, from what I've seen, I don't think I've played all of the maps, but it's by far the longest and most complex and most fun level, most varied. It's kind of the end of these little 3 tutorial missions that you play through. There's at least 10 maps, I think, to play through. But as to the longevity of the game, I can't really talk to that. As you can see, these guys are pretty high level that I'm playing with, so they're having a good time. Good enough to get to that level, in a way. So here's the tower. Oh, the tower garrison, in a way. Kill that guy. Some very tight areas in here as we go up this lift and up through the stairs and stuff. So it's generally bad for us. Although it can be good. It's bad against some of these special rats, like the ogre and the globeleer guy. But when you're fighting a massive horde, the enclosed areas can actually be quite good, because you can force them into the narrow paths and just cut them into chunks. And it's pretty awesome. That's a horn going off. That's not the horn we're going for, but that is going to cause a massive lump of them to spawn, I think. Here they come. Some fire going. It's nice that they made the Bright Wizard, who is, I guess, someone you wouldn't associate with melee prowess. Although I could be completely wrong. I don't know much about the Warhammer Fantasy universe, I'm going to be honest. But it's nice that they made her feel pretty solid in melee combat still. Wow, this guy's still alive. There he goes. Indrid killed him, that's right. So Yorg needs to heal. There we go. And is this where the horn is? No. I've done this. What's this? Potion of Strength, I'll take it. That buffs your damage. Also, it buffs your range damage as well. I'm pretty certain of that. Even though it's called a Potion of Strength, it doesn't just buff your melee damage. There's also a Potion of Speed, which increases your movement speed and your attack speed. So that can be really powerful. Especially if it's on something that already has good attack speed, like the Witch Hunter's Rapier, which Pib is not using. You see, he's swinging as some kind of two-handed sword. I'm not sure what that is, but it's pretty cool. That's for sure. There's another Potion of Strength or whatever that is. Okay. I always feel like there's freaking Skaven behind me. Them big charged attacks can be risky, because if they hit you while you're swinging your sword, they will knock you out of that animation. Where are these guys going? Where are they coming from? Down there. Bunch of healing items here because they're setting you up for a big fight. Can you just put the tomes down here and carry a healing item with you and then come and get it back? Guessing you can. So basically we want to blow this giant horn to ask for help, which doesn't work out very well for us. Just calls a bunch of Skaven. Maybe it does ask for help as well. But there's going to be a big fight here. Loads of Skaven coming down these pillars. Very, very fun to shoot them down. I don't know if we want a 2-and-2 formation. I don't know if special rats can spawn on this thing, or if it's just a regular horde. So I'm going to stick with Yorg here and shoot these guys off these pillars. Beautiful. Those fireballs. Don't heal your... Don't. Just vent a little bit there. Oh, that hurt me, that vent. And you missed that rat twice. Well done. So it's all kicking off here. Pib and Osinski taking the stairs, and we will try and hold the top here. I do have a Potion of Strength, and I do have that bomb, but both of those take time to use. So it can be tricky to get them out when it gets really hectic. Ouch. That was painful. Okay, looks like a bunch of dudes spawning from over there. Are they? Maybe not.
Look to the shadows. If you see beady eyes in the
You get an extra dice just for doing it on normal. Let's throw my bomb here. Yes! That was satisfying. Oh, there's a little one of those storm vermin or whatever they're called down there. Oh, one up here as well. Let's throw a fireball in his face. So the normal attack for my sword is not armor penetrating, so I need to use my charge attack. There we go, for that guy. I am really low on health now. Holy crap. Did not realize how much damage those guys were doing. I want to try and take my Potion of Strength here. So my range attacks are going to be, ouch, a lot more effective. Need to be so careful. Don't want to go down. I think you get more of something. Maybe it's just more XP if there are no revives, or do you? Do you just need to get all the heroes to the end? I'm not sure. You would think they'd reward not having a revive and that kind of thing. Continue throwing those fireballs down there. That storm vermin is down. Here's another one. It's like he's spawning out of thin air. Some of the animations are janky, as I mentioned. Especially on this area. Oh, well, since he's gone down. And Pip has gone down. Hopefully we can revive them. I'm very, very low on health. Gonna try and revive Osinski here. And revive Pip. Okay. That worked out okay. This fight seems to be a lot longer and hard. Not just more dangerous enemies or more of them, but a longer fight overall, more waves of stuff. Don't take hits, Indrid, you need to block. Somehow, I've gained a little bit of health. Oh, it's because of the trait of my staff. I have a small chance on hit to recover some health, I think, the bloodlust trait. That's cool, it actually helped me out here. It's a tiny, tiny chance, it's like 5.5%. But I guess when you're killing tons and tons of Skaven, I think we've done this here. As you can see, Pib and Asinski are bleeding out, but we have three tomes, and they should be okay, because the end is just around the corner here. They can screw you on this corner, though. I have come around here and found a couple of rat gunners, which have then, like, wiped out three people, so you need to be careful. Looks like nothing has spawned here. Oh, yeah, just a few regular fellas. Let's get into the coach. Alessia has got us through. There we are, victorious. So here is where it breaks down the experience you get. Get three times the XP for hard, I think. And we got a bunch of bonus dice. There we go. Looks like we did have a grimoire. I leveled up. I got a mercenary greatsword. Is that for the soldier? I have no idea. And this is where you roll for dice. The Reynolds bones, apparently. Let's see what we do. We have a massive dice pool. We got... is that four? Does that green one count? We got a blue thing. Looks like a staff, but I don't know what that is. Seems like a pretty good roll. I'm three from the top. However this thing works. It's a staff. It's a blazing ember cage staff. A bolt staff. Pretty cool. I've got bloodlust on here and channeling rune. Okay, that's pretty cool. Might be able to try out a bolt staff. And here it breaks down the kills. I got the most range kills as you expect for my Bright Wizard. We've got most revives for me for some reason. Oh, I revived Pib and Asinski. We've got kills. Special kills, maybe that's some special attacks, headshots, melee kills, damage dealt, and it's damage taken as well. Where is that? There it is, Osinski. And then you vote where you want to go back. We'll head back into the inn. And we're back in the inn. And that's some Warhammer End Times Vermintide for you guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. And thanks to these players for joining me too. Jorg, Pib, and Osinski. Couldn't have got through it without them, that's for sure.